Hi everyone, it's Jenna Massio from McLean Fitness. Today I have a CrossFit inspired workout again that I created. It's a lot of cardio mixed in with some weights, some of our standard CrossFit style exercises, and the formats are should make it interesting. So we're going to start with a warm up. It's going to be a bodyweight warm up, and then the rest is going to involve kettlebells, dumbbells, and barbells. I do have my jump rope too for some cardio. We're just gonna jump rope. You don't have to have a jump rope, you can just simulate it. You can even pretend that you're doing like double unders if you don't have a jump rope. I'm just gonna do single reps when we get to that. So we'll start with the Tabata warm up, which is going to be just air squats, kind of with a stretch to get deep, because we got a lot of squats. And then I'm gonna do planks with the shoulder rotation. So we're gonna go ahead and start, and hopefully this will get you fully warmed up. We're gonna go in 10 seconds. So I'll squat and kind of stretch inner thighs, outer thighs. We're gonna go in 3 seconds. Coming down, deep, stretch, and then squeezing up. Coming down, and stretch. Down, I'm like pushing my knees out, and then squeezing my glutes when I come up. And you're gonna sit down deep. Next is the plank, and we're just going to rotate our shoulders. So hands below the shoulders, and what you're doing is rotate this way, and kind of swimmer arms, I guess you could call it. Just working on that shoulder rotation. So going back, and then going forward. And keeping that core tight. Seconds. So going deep, chest up, and then pulling up. Try and go up and down straight, and make sure you're squeezing your glutes as you come up. All right, plank with the shoulder rotation. Hopefully you can see my timer. We're going in 5 seconds. Start with the other arm. So try and prevent your hips from rotating. Try and having them face the ground as best as possible. All right. We're halfway there. 2 more minutes of this warm up. Toes out a little bit, stretch, and breathe, keeping that core tight. And we're going to go into a nice little 30-second EMOM with increasing reps each round. This will be a 12-minute EMOM. That's what we're going to start with. We'll start with like less reps, so we'll kind of slowly get you into the workout. All right, 3 seconds, plank. Around and forward. I adapted some of this stuff, and I will make sure to list, to list some of the YouTube channels that I adapted a lot of this stuff from. I love the idea of a 30-second EMOM. It's really not an EMOM, but basically 30 seconds to complete exercises as opposed to our typical minute. And that was Funk Roberts that I saw that with, and I thought it was a cool concept. And you'll start with longer breaks, and then your breaks will get shorter as the rounds increase. Or adding each round will add a rep or two, depending on the exercise. So I just kind of changed up the exercises. All right, this is it, last exercise. And then we'll start with that 30-second EMOM. done with our Tabata. So I will get the timer ready for 30 seconds and our four exercises. So basically, these will be in sets of like 2 minutes, but you're gonna do 30 seconds of each of these four exercises. Your first exercise will be one double press, but we'll increase each round we do the double press by one. Then we're gonna do two sumo deadlifts with the kettlebell, and we'll increase by two for that exercise. The third exercise is a clean and press, and we're gonna increase by one, so starting with one. And then we'll finish with swings, starting with two swings, increasing by two each round. So we are going to start. I have my kettlebell. So this is gonna be my kettlebell. I'm gonna use dumbbells, and I'm gonna adjust my dumbbells based on the amount of reps. So I might start with 30s on the clean and press, and then maybe go to 25s. Double press, I'm just gonna stick to the 25s. All right, so this is a 12-minute set, and hopefully this will fully get you ready for the rest of the workout, since we're starting with just low reps. So this is a 30-second, on the 30-second, 24 rounds. We're gonna start in 5 seconds with our one double press. So I'm gonna grab my 25s, and the double press is pretty much a burpee with a dynamic. So down, push up, coming up, and pressing the weights up. All right, that's it, and you rest. Okay, so this is a long rest, obviously. We have 18 minutes, or 18 seconds. I'm gonna change it so you can see it. And then we're gonna go into our sumo deadlift. And I'm gonna do two, and I'm gonna use my kettlebell. I'm gonna straddle it. We're going in 5 seconds. So pulling up, so sumo, sorry, a little wide. So I have enough time to do two. Rest it. So I'm going to use my 30s for my one clean and press. We have 15 seconds. We're going in eight. I feel like it is actually going faster than I thought it would. Going in 3 seconds. So clean the weights up and then press and then back down. All right. So then I'm going to go to my kettlebell for my two swings. So the deadlift, the swings, I'm gonna increase by two every round, everything else, one. So this first round, somewhat easy. It'll increase as we move along. 5 seconds, two swings, one, and two. All right, we are on to two double presses. Four sumo deadlifts, two clean and presses, and four swings. And we got 15 seconds. So really allowing our heart rate to come down. The double presses, I believe, will probably be the hardest part of this whole workout. We have two coming up in 3 seconds. So pressing it up, we got one more. You're done with that. That makes me a little nervous that I had to do six at one point. So I got sumo. We'll see if I can make it. This wide stance. We have four sumos. Going in 3 seconds. Coming down. So one, two, three, and four. Two clean and presses. I'm worried about the devil press. Eight seconds. If I go over, I'll go over, but because I'll have plenty of time, I think, with my sumos. All right, clean and press for two. Clean it up. Press. Clean it up. And press. All right. We have four swings. 15 seconds. Stretch anything you need to stretch. 8 seconds. Four swings. Standing behind your bell. One, two, three, and four. All right, round two's done. We have three double presses. Six, three, and six. All right, double press for three. This one takes a lot. 3 seconds. Power it up. One. Two. And three. All right, 10 seconds. That's bad. All right, we have six with the sumos. One, two, three, four, five, six. All right, three clean and presses. Okay, 15 seconds. Starting to get harder. All right, going in 3 seconds. I have three. One, two, and three. All right, six swings. All right, getting ready. Six swings. One, two, three, four, five, and six. All right, back to the start. We have four with a double press. Eight, four, and eight. Double press, we're not gonna have much for eight. Rest. Going 3 seconds. One. Two. Three. And four. 8 seconds. And sumos. For eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. All right, four clean and presses. I'm starting to pick up a little bit. I'll probably do this for the last time with the 30s. One, two, three, and four. Swings. I might need to try one more round. We'll see. Swings. Eight. Go in 3 seconds. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. All right, we got four double presses. We're going to go right into our 10 sumos. Just get this ready. Going in 5 seconds. Two. Three. Four. And five. All right, sumos. For 10. One. Three, four, five, six, 5, clean and process. Last time for 30s. I promise. 25 for the last round. 10 swings. Going in 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Alright. 6, 12, 6, 12. I might run over on the double press, which is fine. I'm just gonna go right into 12 sumos. 3 seconds. Declining rep as well as burpees. So starting with 10 hand cleans, 10 burpees. I'm gonna do competition burpees. So really like your body comes all the way down to the ground. So we'll do 10, 10, and then 8, 8, all the way until we get to 2 reps. Starting with our jumper. So I'm gonna change my weights on my hand cleans just based on the amount of reps. All right, so you should get stronger and go heavier each round. So this is 100. I'll move this way. please. We have 10 hand cleans. I'm gonna use my sandbag for this first round. It's only 40 pounds, so should be doable. So coming down hanging and going down squat. One, two, three, four, five, six. You can use dumbbells. Seven, use what you have. Eight, I got two more. Nine, and 10. 10 burpees, competition style. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, two more, nine, last one. We have four more rounds. Decreasing reps on the hand clean. Sorry, my hair is falling in my face. So, going back to my jump rope. The goal is to do 100 without messing up. Here we go. Three, four, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Focus. 15. 50. So moving on up. So hold that weight. Coming down. One. And reset. Two. Three. Keeping that core tight. Four. Burpees, competition style. One, feeling the sand. Two, three, four, five, six. Seven. All right, back to jump rope. Round three. Catch your breath. 100 reps. I find that when I focus, I don't miss. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Honey. Competition style. One, two, three, four, five, last one, and six. Round. We have two rounds. Here we go. Heart rate is up. Stay with me. 10. 20. Last round, two reps. Don't want to overthink the jump rope there. Here we go. 10. 20. One and two. gonna do pull-ups. So I want you to use whatever you have. It's not high rep pull-ups. What we're gonna be doing is I'm gonna set up three weights. We're gonna do single arm push press. Three different weights for one rep. So you do one arm, the other arm, then higher, heavier, heavier, and then heavier, heavier, and one pull-up. Then we'll do two, flowing through those three set of weights, three pull-ups, I'm sorry, two pull-ups, then three, and then three pull-ups. Then we're gonna go back in reverse. And when we go back in reverse, I wanna start heavy and then go low, lighter. So for my push press, I'm gonna start with slow reps, guys. So we'll do 25, 30, and then a 35, hopefully I can get that 35 up there. Single arm though too, so shouldn't be too bad. I have it all set up here. So 1, 1, 1, 1. And then 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. You got it, right? One on each arm. So bring it up. So I did get this from someone that I like to follow. Step it back. One on this arm. We're kind of doing a clean. And then pressing it up. You can use a kettlebell or a dumbbell. Back for that 35. All right, one pull up. Not my favorite pull up bar. I'm actually gonna do closed grip just because this bar is not the greatest. So up for one and then down. All right, two reps on each side. So bring it up. One, two, other side. One, two. Right, it's a push press. So legs giving a little assist there. You're really focusing on the negative to help you get stronger. And two, one. Clean it. One and two. All right, two pull-ups. One. I want you to come all the way down and chest to the bar. Okay, we're on to three. So we'll do something with legs after this set. One, two, three. One, two, and three. One, core tight, two, and three. One, two, and three. Three fives. One, two, three. Challenge yourself. One. It's only three reps, okay? And then three. So we'll flow through that again for three after my three pull-ups. One, two, and three. All right. Start from the back, three, three, three. So heavy to low. One, two, three. One, two, three. do it pretty quick. Substitute something for that pull-up if you don't have a pull-up bar. Something for your back. Since this is working our push segment, you want to pull. Two reps. One. You can do chin-ups too. Two. All right, one rep. Last round for this. One. One, you got that clean in there too. One. One. And one. All right, one pull up. One. And down. All right. Of that, we're going to move on to a leg set, somewhat similar. We're just going to alternate between squats and deadlifts. We're going in that pyramid style too. So I'm going to do this with dumbbells. I'll do my dumbbells for the squats, but for my deadlifts, I'm going to use kettlebells. I'm just going to use what I have. So I have a 45, a 50, and then a 70. The reps are going to be a little bit different. We're going to go from 1, 3, 5, and then 5, 3, 1. So I'm going to get my dumbbells set up. I'm going to use 25s, 30s, and then 40s. A lot of reps, guys. You can use your kettlebell too if you want. Choose what you have and try to get into that pyramid format. So starting with one of each of these, and then one of the sumo, or I'm sorry, just regular standard or RDLs. So grabbing your weights, sitting back, that's one. Coming up, squat, down. Pulling up, squat. Standard. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down. All right. One or two rep round. Whew. Not a lot of reps, my heart rate's up. Alright. Two reps. One. I'm sorry. Three reps. We're going that way. Sorry. Don't want to cheat that. Three reps. One. Two. Three. One. Three on each. One, two, and three. One, two, three. One, two. We have our five reps now to finish and get to the peak, but we'll repeat. Take back breaks if you need it. One, two, sit back on your heels. Three, four, and five. three, four, and five. One, two, three, four, and five. All right, deadlifts. My hands are getting sweaty. One, two, three, four, hinging, soft knees, two, three, four, and five. One, two, three, four, and five. All right, so I'm gonna start with my heavy for the five reps in this round. One, two, three, four, try and keep your chest up as best as possible. Two, three, four, and five. One, two, three, four, three, four, and five. Make sure you're squeezing, keeping that core tight. One, two, three, four, and five. After this, we're moving to three reps. One, two, three, four, and five. All right, three reps with your squats. Oh, this is killer. All CrossFit stuff is never gonna be easy, you know that. One, two, one, two, and three. All right, don't lose focus. We're close to the end. One, two, and three. I like setting it up so it flows through easily. Three reps. One, two, and three. Keeping that core tight. We're doing a lot of leg. Your back, you want to protect it. One, two, and three. One, two, and three. we go. And you can use whatever weight you have to make it like this pyramid drop set style, okay? One. It's just easier with dumbbells because you don't have to switch out weights, but you could do like a dumbbell to a sandbag to a kettlebell, whatever works. One. Clean up my area while I explain what the last finisher looks like. So I'm going to do everything with my barbell. So kind of, it's going to be a complex. We're just going to do it three times through, starting with 10 reps of an exercise, going 8, 6, 4, and 2. If you don't want to use your barbell or if you don't have one, you can do most of these exercises with dumbbells, obviously, definitely with dumbbells. Kettlebells, the burpee clean might be a little bit, burpee clean and press might be a little bit awkward. You can do like a diamond push-up though, or some sort of push-up for the burpee. Just make it work for you. So 10 deadlifts, 8 power cleans, into 6 front squats, 4 rows, so bent over rows, and then 2 burpee clean and presses. I'm gonna use my 70. Good enough at this point. All right, 3 times. Grabbing my weight for 10. Like really sweaty where it's losing the grip. Safety first, guys. So important. Whew. All right. Round 2. I like doing things for 3 rounds. Mentally easier. This is higher reps at this point, too. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, two more. 7, 8, 6 squats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Four bent rows. 1, 2, 3, 4. Two clean and presses for the burpee. Under an hour. Unless you take like a 5 minute break, then it won't be. Trying my best to let my heart come down. It's hard to not want to jump into that last set to be done. But take your time. Grip, just feeling it. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 8 power cleans. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6. My grip. 1, 2, 3. I'm just trying to make sure I go deep. 4, 5, 6. Four bent rows. 1, 2, 3, 4. My forearms are on fire. One more. Then we're done. Down. Try to make sure you're walking around to assist in that. So once again, make sure you stretch. I know I don't do it here or tape it. It's kind of boring to watch me stretch. So, and I don't know what you need to stretch the most, okay? So for this sort of exercise, it's full body. But I always feel like the back and shoulders on CrossFit really get worked. So make sure you stretch them really well. Also, drink water. So important to hydrate yourself. And obviously getting your vitamin D keeps you happy. So in these times, it's very useful. But you should take it all the time if you can't get it outside. So I hope you enjoyed this. Please let me know if you like this, if you like to do the jump roping, whatever. Thanks for joining in, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.